Hey Grio fam, I'm Gerren Keith Gaynor, managing editor at theGrio, and this is Grio Top 3, powered by the Dear Culture podcast, which I co-host alongside Shauna Pennick, social media director here at theGrio. And here at Grio Top 3, we give you the top 3 trending stories of the day. Coming in at number 3, Bobby Brown and Keith Sweat are facing off in the latest Verzuz battle. Two titans of rhythm and blues are going to battle it out in the next Verzuz event. Bobby Brown and Keith Sweat. And the good news is that fans won't have to wait long to witness the matchup. The popular competition series originated during the coronavirus pandemic as millions of Americans hunkered down in their homes during quarantine. Creators Swiss Beatz and Timbaland provided hours of entertainment as black producers and eventually artists, each playing 20 of their best songs, with social media and pundits ultimately declaring a winner. On Thursday, July 1st, as part of the Essence Festival of Culture, old school favorite Sweat, who turned 60 on July 22nd, and Brown, 52, will take the stage against each other. The popular festival is still mostly virtual, with a schedule of streaming concerts still inspired by A Taste of New Orleans, which is where the event originated. Essence and Verzuz both made the announcement on Tuesday, sparking a day of excitement on social media. The flyer for the event was inspired by an Essence magazine cover. Both Brown and Sweat had major careers in the 1980s and 1990s, and both were members of a group at one point, and they even have a group member in common in Johnny Gill. There was LSG, representing the late Gerald Levert, Sweat, and Gill, and with Brown, there's New Edition, which Gill joined after his 1985 departure to go solo. Folks saying Keith Sweat will get mopped by Bobby Brown need to understand that Sweat's career goes from 1987 to 2000, longtime writer Keith Murphy contended on Twitter. Like, dude has a heavy bag. Like I said, Bobby definitely needs that New Edition heat to give him an edge. This Verzuz is going to be very interesting. Another fan tweeted, "The way I'm about to be Roger Rabbiting, cabbage patching, and doing the running man all throughout this Bobby Brown and Keith Sweat Verzuz, the new Jack Swing era was just perfection in every way." I don't know who you have your money on, but I cannot wait for this Verzuz battle. Coming in at number 2, Disney star Kyle Massey is charged for alleged interactions with a minor. Kyle Massey, best known for his role as Corey Baxter on Disney's That's So Raven, is facing a felony charge of one count of immoral communication with a minor after sending an explicit video to a 13-year-old girl. According to court documents filed on June 14th in King County, Washington, the charge comes after the girl sued Massey in 2019 for sending her numerous sexual explicit text messages, images, and videos. The minor, who was not named due to her age, has known Massey since she was 4 years old. The girl and her family met him back in 2009 at Universal City, where he exchanged numbers with her mother. They remained in contact with the Disney star because the family was interested in getting her into the entertainment business and have regarded Massey as a mentor and father figure. The minor claims that Massey, 29, developed a friendly and seemingly harmless relationship with her mother, and even invited the child to fly out to Los Angeles. The alleged intention was to help her find an agent. He even offered the teen a chance to stay with him and his girlfriend at their home, according to People magazine. The girl and her mom claimed that following the invite in December, Massey began sending the girl numerous sexual explicit text messages, images, and videos, including an image of Massey holding his penis with a corresponding text message that read, "LOL, just me messing with you, LOL." The girl filed a report with the sheriff's office, and her family are suing for at least $1.5 million. In response, Massey claimed he was being extorted and denied all allegations. The actor reportedly failed to appear at his arraignment Monday in King County Criminal Court in Washington. Coming in at number 1, Chauncey Billups' hiring as a head coach for the Blazers draws backlash over 1997 rape allegation. The new head coach of the Portland Trail Blazers, Chauncey Billups, dodged questions about 1997 sexual assault allegations during a news conference where his hiring was announced. A public relations professional interrupted before Billups could answer a question where he was asked about the incident, which he has previously said shaped his life in unbelievable ways. The PR rep said, "We've addressed this, it's been asked and answered." Neil Olshey, the Blazers' president of basketball operations, did not elaborate on the results of an independent investigation into the incident that the team had commissioned. The findings of that incident corroborated Chauncey's recollection of the events that nothing non-consensual happened, he said. "We stand by Chauncey, everyone in the organization." Olshey said that the team considered the case as well as the input of other stakeholders, including players like team star Damian Lillard, who supported the candidacy of Billups and Jason Kidd. "But at the end of the day," Olshey said, "this is an organizational decision, and the organization believes that Chauncey is the best person to be our head coach." Billups was never charged in the case and settled a civil case with a woman known in the filings only as Jane Doe. "I learned at a very young age as a player, and not only a player, but a young man and young adult, that every decision has consequences," Billups said on Tuesday in addressing the accusation. "And that's led to some really, really healthy but tough conversations I've had to have with my wife, who was my girlfriend at the time, and my daughters about what actually happened and about what they may have to read about me in the news." This has been Grio Top 3, powered by the Dear Culture Podcast. For more episodes, visit our YouTube page. For more stories, visit thegrio.com. And be sure to subscribe to the Dear Culture Podcast wherever you listen to your podcast. Thanks for tuning in, and see you next time.